What's up, everybody? Dave back again. I have a promo to also slash review type thing. This is one of my own products. I have gotten into modding. First off, I need to thank a couple people. Shan Burkholder on YouTube as Shan Burkholder also runs vapecore.com. She's helped me so much through this whole thing. She basically ran into me at VapeFest and said, I'm going to help you with your modding. Shan, I can't thank you enough for taking those couple weeks to just sit with me and go over stuff and show me exactly what I was doing. So I need to thank her first off. Also, Jolly at jollyrificmods.com has sat with me and gone over some stuff with me, and mainly with the supply aspect of it, has gone over this with me. So first off, thank you both. I am eternally indebted to you. Now, getting into the mod itself. This is known as the Bunyip Box. What a Bunyip is an Australian mythical creature. Not even going into how the name came up. But what this box is a standard 3.7 volt box. It's a 3AA box. Of course, my personal one is this one. They come with a black button, and as of right now, only the black button, and they have a blue LED, or you can get no LED. Possible in the future I could do different button colors and different LED colors, but as of right now, making batches of them, I refuse to sit on them. So, as of right now, these are available through smartvapes.com. Smartvapes.com is run by my good friend Shiny Paladin, also known as Alan, has some of the lowest prices in the industry, like $5.99 for atomizers, does sales to where they go down to like $4.99 for atomizers. This Bunyip box is going for $28. What this box is again 3.7 volts. I only have one battery on me right now. I can't for the life of me find my other one, but it runs off two 14500s, and I will take them out just to kind of show you the insides here. It runs off two 14500s. I'm kind of toying with the idea of leaving my wires open. I'm not positive, but on the ones that are for sale right now, they all are covered and sealed so that there's no possibility of screwing any connections up. They're already made. If there is any issues, I have asked for them to be dealt through me. Anyway, getting back into this, it's a 3.7 volt box, so you get to run two 14500s. You can end up getting one of these rated at 900 mAh a piece, so you're going to get 1800 mAh out of a box mod. Good way to start with 3.7, good starter mod for people, but is going to run off of two 14500s. The main reason that I came up with this was because I hate 14500 batteries because they're only 900 mAh. I go through that in a few hours, so I figured if I could actually get a 3AA box that would run two batteries, you could get a longer battery life. I've heard people, Shiny Paladin mainly, went 4 days on the same two batteries. They were hydrogen batteries, they're fantastic batteries. But they do run off of any protected 14500. If you use the IMRs that do not have the nipples on the top, you do need a magnetic spacer for it to make contact. So the other nice thing is if you don't want to run the two 14500s, it will run off of just one battery. So you just pop the battery in there, you pop the cover on it here, you hit the button, and you vape away. The on-off switch is functional, so you hit the off button, not going to fire. I use the standard horn switch, and I use a sealed 510 connector, so there's no risk of any juice or anything going down and screwing up any of the wiring on the inside. So I'm going to go ahead and take a vape off of this. Standard resistance atomizer, 3.7 volts. Not to toot my own horn. This thing hits like a train, even on one battery. So again, it is true 3.7 volts. It will run off one or two 14500 batteries. Right now it's available at smartvapes.com. Shiny Paladin is just a fantastic guy. He's a good friend of mine. So head over to smartvapes.com, check it out. These will be for sale through a couple other sites here fairly soon. Just kind of got to get the ball rolling with those. But as of right now, the only place that these are available is smartvapes.com. They're going for about $28. He has $2 shipping on everything. Again, has some of the cheapest juice, atomizers, has Ego kits, Ego T kits, and now he carries these mods. These are in stock right now. He only has a very, very limited supply of them. So if this is something you think that you would like, definitely head over there and jump on it pretty quick. He has the batteries, the chargers, and everything to go with it. So It is vented also at the top. There is the vent hole in case something would happen and your batteries decide they need to vent. However, you need to use protected batteries. I cannot stress this enough. IMR batteries are fine, but they are not protected. Please remember this. Also, if you choose to use a drip shield, like I am, and use a 510 atomizer, I've said this a couple times and how it's actually going to get dealt with. I haven't had the issue yet, but the 510 to 901 and the 901 to 510 bridge connectors that you need to use a 510 with a drip shield, and also the 510 to 510 adapters that are sold by Avid Vapor and Mad Vapes, if you screw those down too tight in this connector, that center pin is going to get crushed and the silicone piece underneath it is going to get crushed. Now, this isn't just with this mod. This is with any mod out there, but this is mine, so that's why I'm saying this disclaimer. If you screw those down too tight and then you crank your atomizer down and it crushes that, you're not going to be able to use a normal atomizer on it, and over time, you're not going to be able to use it even with the adapters. So please be careful about this, because that is not warrantied through me. I don't believe it's warrantied through Smart Vapes. So please, please be wary of, if you use adapters, do not screw them down too tight, because you do risk causing damage to the connector on the top. So, like I said, this is just a disclaimer. That's not going to be covered if I see that that silicone piece is crushed in there. Like I said, I have no problem replacing parts and pieces for anybody. If the mod goes bad, I have no problem replacing the mod. But if it's physical damage not caused by anything that I had to do with, I'm very wary about fixing stuff like that. If you want me to fix the connector, you want me to do anything like that, fine. But like I said, please be worried about the adapters, and please use protected batteries. So, now that the disclaimers are done, like I said, available at smartvapes.com, 3.7 volt box. I have very, very small hands. This is fairly easily concealed in a palm. Compared size-wise, I have my Ego sitting over here. Size-wise to an Ego, of course it's going to be a little bit wider. They're about the same size lengthwise, but if you would picture holding three AA's in your hand, that's about how big this is. So it's a very, very sturdy box. I had to end up finding a new source for boxes because I wasn't happy with the quality of the old ones that I was getting. So it slides together, slides on and off very easily. I haven't had any issues with it. The on-off button, like I said, is functional, and the atomizer connection is sealed. So use the standard horn button with an LED. Right now, on his site, all he has is the blue LED option or no LED option. Like I said, in future, we'll see how these go. I could potentially do different ones. But for right now, it's going to come with a black horn button, and it's going to come with a blue LED. So head over to smartvapes.com. If you guys have any questions about it, feel free to shoot an email to shinypaladin@smartvapes.com. I don't know his email address through that site, so I apologize for that. But if you have any questions about them that you want to come to me for, I'm available on Skype at VaporVW, on Twitter at VaporVW, or if you just want to go through his website, he can shoot any questions through me. So I hope you guys like it. This is the first mod that I've ever actually sold in a mass production line. And once again, thank you so much to Jan and Shali. Jan and Shali? Wow. Shan and Jolly. I can't thank you guys enough. So head over to smartvapes.com, and I hope if you guys end up buying this that you will give me some feedback on it. So once again, this is my first mod that I've done mass production with, and I can't wait to see how this goes.